Now, with all of that, you might be surprised to learn that when I first brought Maya into our family, my immediate focus was not on suppressing her chasing instincts. It was to build a solid partnership foundation. Foundation first. That's my mantra. Now, this is critical. Before attempting to train behaviors or special skills like for dog sports, the trusting bond between human and canine needs to be well established. So, where did I begin with Maya, this crazy dog that had failed out of three homes already? Well, I begin at the beginning, of course, by building our foundation. So, here are the highlights of the important pieces of what I was focusing on. Hi, I'm Kathy Kawalec, and I believe that our dogs connect us to the heart and soul of what really matters in life. So hang out, and we'll take a deep dive into the human-dog connection and explore strategies that will inspire you to create legendary, enlightened partnership with your dog. This is the Enlightened by Dogs podcast. Well, hello there. This is Kathy Kowalik, your host of the Enlightened by Dog Show. And today I'm going to dive into a story that's really close to my heart. I think of it as a tale of transformation, perseverance, and an illustration of the undeniable power of partnership. Now, the reason I'm sharing this story is because it represents the magnitude of the reactivity, over-arousal, and difficult behaviors that are challenging even the most caring and informed dog moms these days. And here's the thing, I don't want you to give up, and I don't want you to stay discouraged if you are. No matter how difficult or overwhelming things seem with your dog right now, I want you to know that there is hope and that there's a better way. All right, so let's journey back to when Maya, my beautiful border collie, entered my life. At just 6 or 7 months old, this sweet pup had already been passed in and out of three homes. Each of them labeled her as untrainable. I mean, it was bad. There's no denying it. She chased children until they cried. She chased livestock without a second thought. Fences? Well, they were merely a challenge for her to solve. Even experienced dog handlers and trainers had failed with her, resorting to methods that weren't in Maya's best interest, let's say. Now, with all of that, you might be surprised to learn that when I first brought Maya into our family, my immediate focus was not on suppressing her chasing instincts. It was to build a solid partnership foundation. Foundation first. That's my mantra. Now, this is critical. Before attempting to train behaviors or special skills like for dog sports, the trusting bond between human and canine needs to be well established. So, where did I begin with Maya, this crazy dog that had failed out of three homes already? Well, I begin at the beginning, of course, by building our foundation. So, here are the highlights of the important pieces of what I was focusing on. I made a list. So, number one, role modeling. I integrated Maya directly into our family so that I could demonstrate how we live together, how we do things as a family. This is what natural cultural learning is all about. Like, it's about understanding the ethos of this is what we do in our family. Number two, meeting Maya's three core needs. It was essential for her to feel heard, to have a strong sense of belonging, and to feel that she was contributing to our family dynamic. Number three, belief in perfection. Looking past Maya's behavior challenges, I communicated a single message to her day after day after day, no matter what. You are perfect just the way you are. With reactive dogs, this belief and communicating this belief is always the starting point. Number four, patience. There was no rush, no preset timeline, no pressure. We lived in the moment, learning from each other and taking baby steps. Number five, the clarity framework. Each decision I made every day with what to do and how to handle things with Maya was passed through a litmus test. Does it build trust and confidence? Is it moving us closer to our desired outcome of having a brilliant partnership? If not, if I couldn't get three solid yeses, well, I tried something else that did. Number six, the partnership dance steps. Incorporating our core dance steps into our daily activities fostered connection and communication and, of course, nurtured trust. The dance invitation and the 95% rule, well, let's just say that changes everything, and it did with Maya. Number seven, communication. Ensuring that we became competent communicators in a dialogue loop before any formal training began. This was really important. Number eight, maybe this is, I saved the best for last. I don't know, but it's really, really important. New story, new chapter. Even though Maya was a dog that skirted past two appointments for behavioral euthanasia and endured many tactics in the name of trying to fix her dangerous behavior, I never thought of her as damaged or abused or needing to be fixed or as someone needing to be rescued. I saw her for who she was, a brilliant, incredibly smart, persistent, and deeply misunderstood dog who would lead the way to a new and brighter future for both of us. All right, now, instead of trying to train her to be obedient to my cues or commands, I poured energy into nurturing our relationship by fostering trust and understanding, the cooperative behaviors that I needed, that I wanted, that she wanted too, just naturally align themselves without any direct intervention. Now, this approach was complemented with our partnership dance steps, including the ever-important dance invitation. Now, here's a little tidbit to illustrate our progress. On our daily walks, instead of obsessively chasing and trying to control the other dogs, which was like Maya's MO, right? Well, she began to respond to my invitations to connect. And following what I consider to be the all-important 95% rule, I couldn't directly invite Maya because I knew she wouldn't respond when there was any kind of movement, right? So I started by inviting my other dogs to connect with me and get some love. And soon Maya noticed that and she wanted some love too. And so she started to respond to my invitations to the other dogs. Yeah. So it was like win and win. And this was completely on her own. She was coming right into my hands. And of course, when she did, she got all the love she deserved. And so in the span of just a few months, she was literally transformed. where once she would have been in full chase, couldn't hear a word I said or didn't even know I existed. Now she'd stop on a dime from a full run at any distance away from me and return to me with just a sweet and simple invitation. Our partnership blossomed, and after about 6 months of this foundational work, we began our sheepdog herding training. Now, my decision to wait for 6 months wasn't because of her inherently strong chase drive, but because I didn't want to trigger her old chasing behavior patterns that she had built in the past. And I really wanted to ensure that was behind us, that we had established some new patterns of behavior and connection together. But when we did start, oh my goodness, she was a natural, and our connection was so solid and so strong. And fast forward to just 1 year after that, Maya's winning at the highest level of sheepdog trials, from nursery competitions to open trials. She was literally an unstoppable force. And by the time she was four, Maya had reached, I guess for me, it was a pinnacle, ranking in the top 30 in the North American Border Collie sheepdog standings. I would say that the transformation that she experienced was nothing short of remarkable. From wildly and obsessively chasing anything that moved with no regard for what anyone did to try to stop her, to fluently working with me and listening to my whistle cues up to a mile away from me. From a pup on the brink of a deadly fate to a true champion, our journey together is proof of the wonders of partnership. But let me emphasize this. It wasn't just about the awards and the accolades. It was about Maya's evolution. The once wild puppy who took 20 minutes just to get a leash on her had metamorphosed into an attentive, responsible member of our family and my brilliant partner. Now, to provide an even more vivid picture, let's dive into a specific challenge that we faced about her behavior. Maya's obsession with moving things, combined with her naturally kind nature, in a really interesting way. You see, while she was incredibly sensitive and keen to please, her need to control moving things often took over, as you could imagine. And this juxtaposition made her a complex case for even the most experienced dog families. You know, on one hand, fearlessly busting through doors and fences to chase kids and cattle that no amount of yelling or correcting could stop. And on the other hand, shrinking, shaking, peeing in fear, and desperately needing to be loved and cuddled. Ah, it was interesting. And how did we address this? By normalizing the normal. Through natural social learning and role modeling, I invited her to be a part of our family activities, observing and learning how we coexisted. A vital teaching method I utilized was the 95% rule, as I've already mentioned several times, and I never get tired of talking about it. It's all about setting our dogs up for success. I'd only ask Maya to do something when I was 95% or more certain she'd be able to do the thing that I was about to ask. Why? Because every success creates trust and confidence and cooperation. And finally, our story wouldn't be complete without mentioning the support that Maya received from her furry siblings, my other dogs. I mean, my other dogs played a significant role in Maya's transformation. Their patience, especially during moments like the stick incident with Phoenix, where she grabbed a stick and knocked two of Phoenix's teeth out that needed surgery. Like, so that patience and the connection that we all had together as a family, it was like a community or a family effort. And Maya flourished with that collective love and guidance. So in wrapping this story up, I hope that Maya's story serves as a beacon for all dog moms who are struggling, worried, anxious, or feeling overwhelmed. You know, whether you're navigating life with a dog that is really challenging for you, or raising a pup to be your next brilliant partner, remember that with patience, understanding, and genuine partnership, a happy and harmonious life together is not just possible, it's inevitable. So after listening today, I hope you'll take some time to ask yourself these following questions about your relationship with your own dog, maybe do some journaling. Number one, how and when am I misunderstanding my dog's behavior? When am I making it mean that my dog is giving me a hard time and being difficult? And what else can their behavior mean instead? Number two, am I holding us hostage in our old story? What is our new story? What's our next chapter? What is my vision for our future together? Where can I be a better role model for trusting cooperation to grow and expand? Number four, where am I using training and commands instead of connection and communication? And how can I change that? How can I better normalize the normal as a family of social mammals living collaboratively? And number five, am I consistently using the 95% rule to create successes that nurture confidence and trust? And where are my opportunities to grow in that regard? All right. Well, I hope that this inspires you to continue your journey to partnership and experience all that's possible when you have a brilliant partnership with your beautiful dogs. So that's all I have for you today. Have a great week and be brilliant. Thanks so much for listening. And hey, if you would like to work with me so that I can help you discover the missing pieces you need so that you and your dog can finally be happy and enjoy life together, then head on over to dancingheartsdogacademy.com and request your invitation to join us in the Brilliant Partners Academy when the doors open for the next enrollment. See you next time. And remember, a brilliant partnership with your dog makes your whole life brilliant.